In this session, I will be explaining how to find out the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor. As you know that in DC shunt motor, there are two types of speed control technique. The first method is known as armature controlled speed control technique, and the second method is known as field controlled speed control method. Now let us discuss about armature controlled DC motor. In case of armature controlled DC motor, the field is kept constant where the armature voltage is going to vary. Now let us consider general equation for back EMF that is given by EB is equal to phi Zn by 60 into P by A, where phi is the flux, Z is the number of conductors, N is the speed of motor, P is the number of poles, A is the armature conductor per parallel path. From this equation I can write N is directly proportional to EB by phi, or else N is proportional to 1 by phi. That means, you know, flux is directly proportional to armature current. Therefore, I can write N is proportional to 1 by IA. Please note down the relation. So, as the speed increases, the armature current comes down, or vice versa. As the armature current increases, what is going to happen? Speed is coming down. So, I could find out the relation between speed and armature current. In armature controlled DC motor, the desired speed is obtained by varying armature voltage and the field current is kept constant. That is a true fact regarding armature control technique. Now let us consider the motor. As we can see, this is the entire block diagram of armature controlled DC motor. Here we can see VA is the input. That means armature voltage is the input and theta is the output. Theta is the rotation. The armature that is directly connected with the load through the shaft, that you can directly observe here. In this segment, we can see that the field is kept constant. RF and LF, that is representing the field resistance as well as field inductance. In this case, we will be keeping this field part that is actually constant, where the armature part will be varying. Armature voltage is getting varied. Okay. So, collectively we can say that this is an electromechanical system. It is having both electrical part as well as mechanical part. Electrical part you can observe here. This is electrical part, where the second segment related to load, that is actually mechanical part. So we have to bifurcate electrical part as well as mechanical part. Before moving for the derivation of transfer function, we have to familiar all the terminologies. RI stands for armature resistance, which is expressed in terms of ohm. LI stands for armature inductance in terms of Henry. Similarly, IA represents armature current in ampere. VA represents armature voltage in volt. EB stands for back EMF in volt. KT represents torque constant in Newton meter per ampere. T stands for torque developed by the motor in Newton meter. Theta represents angular displacement of the shaft. J represents moment of inertia of the motor and the load in kilogram meter square per radian. Similarly, B represents the frictional coefficient of the motor and the load. KB indicates the back EMF constant. Before deriving, we need to familiar all the expressions, all the variable as well as constant name separately. Now, we have to derive. Our ultimate aim is to derive the transfer function of the armature controlled DC motor. That is our ultimate aim. You know what is transfer function? Transfer function is nothing but it is the Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input, where all the initial conditions are zero. That is our ultimate aim. First and foremost thing, you need to draw the equivalent circuit of armature. As you can see, this is an equivalent circuit of armature. You have to represent armature resistance RA, then armature inductance LA, and the back EMF and the supply voltage, terminal voltage VA. Now, you have to apply KVL. By looking at the diagram, you can directly apply KVL. If you apply KVL, I will be able to getting IA into RA plus LA into DIA by DT plus EB is equal to VA. Please call this one as equation number 2. That you have to keep in your mind. Now, let us look at the second step. DC motor torque is directly proportional to product of flux into current. That means, the torque is directly proportional to IA. If you want to remove the proportionality constant, I can rewrite torque is given by KT into IA, where KT is nothing but we already defined torque constant in Newton meter per ampere. Please call this one as equation number 2. Now, coming back to third step, this is regarding the load part, mechanical system of the motor that is given below. So, J, that is actually moment of inertia, B is the damper or dashboard, Now theta is the displacement, angular displacement, and T represents torque. Now you can apply Newton's second law. J into d square theta by dt square plus b into d theta by dt, that is equal to tau. Please call this one as equation number 3. Now let us move on step number 4. Vacuum of the DC machine or DC motor is proportional to angular velocity of the shaft. That is a true fact. Now let us write Eb is directly proportional to d theta by dt. Or else, to avoid proportionality constant, I can write Eb is equal to Kb into d theta by dt, where Kb is the vacuum of constant. Please call this equation as number 4. As of now, we are having 4 equations. In order to convert time domain into S domain, it is better to take Laplace transform. By taking Laplace transform, you have to create separate equations. So first equation implies Ia into Ra plus La into S into Ia of S plus Eb of S equal to Va of S. Please call this one as equation number 5. Now taking the Laplace transform of second equation, that means T of S equal to KT into Ia of S. Please call this one as equation number 6. Now moving on to third equation, J S square into theta S plus B theta of S into S, that is equal to T of S. Please call this one as equation number 7. Similarly, coming back to next equation, Eb of S equal to Kb into S into theta of S. So you'll be getting how many equations? Equation number 5, 6, 7, 8. So please make it separate. Now what you can do is, please consider equation number 6 and 7. By looking at equation number 6 and 7, I can equate equation number 6 and 7 directly. Why? Because T of S, you can see that T of S equal to KT into I of S, J square theta of S plus B theta of S into S equal to theta of T of S. I can say that equation number 7 and 8 can be equated. By equating equation number 6 and 7, I will be getting KT into Ia of S equal to J into S square theta of S plus B into theta of S into S. Similarly, separate the value of Ia of S. So, if you separate the value of Ia of S, I will be getting J square plus BS divided by KT into theta of S. Please call this equation as 9. Now, let us call back equation number 5. As you can see, this is actually equation number 5. Please note this one as equation number 5. Please recall equation number 5. Equation number 5 implies Ra plus S into La into Ia plus Eb of S equal to Va of S. Please call this one as equation number 10. Now, what you can do is, substituting for Eb of S and Ia of S from the equation number 8 and 9 in equation number 10, it is nothing but you consider equation number 8 and 9, that has to be substituted in the equation number 10, that you are supposed to do. Whenever you are doing the same operation, you are able to get Ra plus S into La into J square plus Bs by KT into theta of S plus Kb into S into theta of S, that is equal to Va of S. From this, you can take theta of S as a common factor. If you take theta of S as a common factor, the equation will be coming theta of S into Ra plus S into La into J square plus Bs divided by KT plus Kb of S, that is equal to V of S. You can do the simplification. While doing the simplification, this equation becomes theta of S into Ra plus S into La into J square plus Bs plus Kb into S into KT divided by KT, that is equal to V of S. Now what you can do, you can take the ratio of output to the input. What is output? Theta of S. What is the input? V of S. If you take theta of S divided by V of S, that is becoming in terms of a transfer function. That is given by KT divided by Ra plus S into La plus J square plus Bs plus Kb into KT into S. Now please elaborate these terms. You can do the cross multiplication. If you do the cross multiplication, you will be able to get theta of S divided by V of S equal to KT divided by Ra into J square plus Ra into Bs plus La into J cube plus La into Bs square plus Kb into KT into S square. Again, you can simplify. Please take S as a common factor. So, if you take S as a common factor, it is going to become KT divided by S into J into LA into S square plus JRA plus BLA into S plus RAB plus KB into KT. You can close the bracket. While writing the equations, you should be very much careful. Finally, the transfer function TF. I'll be writing transfer function TF, that is given by theta of S by V of S, that is given by KT divided by J into LA. You can take JLA as a common factor from the denominator. That is given by KT by JLA into S into S square plus JRA plus BLA divided by JLA into S plus RAB plus KB KT divided by JLA. This one is actually the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor. So please follow the respective steps and you can easily get the ratio of output to the input. So this is actually the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor. Hope the session is very useful to you. Thanks for watching this video. Please share and subscribe.